We continue on a verdict watch in the Jerry Sandusky trial. It is day two of deliberations in Belfont. And today, Andy Mihalshik has the very latest on what's going on there. Hi, Andy.
Well, hi, Kim. Well, the jury had another question today about another alleged victim, victim number eight. It dealt with testimony from a janitor who said another janitor, a Penn State janitor, saw Sandusky and a young boy in a shower involved in a sex act back in 2000. As you can imagine, as the wait for a verdict continues, so does the speculation.
Jerry Sandusky comes to Center County Court Friday morning as a free man. It could be his last day as a free man as a jury deliberates his fate. Sandusky has said from day one that he's innocent. Well, this day the jury heard a reread of the testimony of Mike McQuarrie and Dr. Jonathan Drainoff. It dealt with an alleged shower incident at Penn State in February of 2001. McQuarrie testified he saw Sandusky standing behind a young boy in a shower at the Lash Building. He told the jury last week that he thought a sex act was taking place. Now, Dr. Drainoff was at McQuarrie's father's home that same night. McQuarrie, according to Drainoff's testimony, told him a different story, that he never saw a sex act, but rather only heard sexual sounds coming from the shower. For 90 minutes Friday, the jury heard the testimony of both McQuarrie and Drainoff read aloud by prosecutors and defense lawyers. Attorney Tom Klein represents alleged victim number five.
The jury, or some number of jurors, has to be looking at the question of what is the degree of crime here. If you discounted or you dismissed the testimony of Mike McQuarrie, that would be the end of it.
And what about the length of deliberations by this jury?
Well, conventional wisdom is that a quick verdict would mean that they just, the jury said, we just don't believe this. The longer it goes, the more the conventional wisdom would be that they're sorting through 48 different verdicts. The jury is being asked to render 48 verdicts, not one, not two, not 10.
Advocates for sexual assault victims say no matter the verdict, the Sandusky case will help victims now and in the future. Kristen Hauser is vice president of the Pennsylvania Coalition Against Rape.
I think it's opening up doors for people to come forward and be believed. There's been much less public victim blaming in this case than we see in many other sexual assault cases. I think it's giving male victims an opportunity to come forward. We've had many brave young men talk about this and pretty much be believed by the general public.
So, Kim, at this point, the jury has asked questions about two of the 10 alleged victims, two victims not known to police. Again, the other eight victims who alleged victims who came to testify, there have been no questions about their cases. Again, the testimony, the deliberations continue here in Center County, Pennsylvania. Kim?
Well, it certainly sounds, Andy, like they're working very hard. We know they deliberated until 9:30 last night. Any idea on what we can expect on how long they'll go today? And if they don't have a verdict, will they go through the weekend?
Well, they will definitely go through the weekend without a doubt. The judge, John Thielen, told them yesterday that it's up to the jury about how long they want to deliberate. And he says, up to you. When you get tired, let me know. But he also made the point, they're sequestered in a local hotel. They cannot go home to their family, so they'll go, they can go as long as they want, but they are not going home until they, if and when they reach a verdict.
All right, we'll let you get back to that verdict watch. We appreciate your time. Thank you, Andy.
Okay, thank you, Kim. Sure.